friends. So in this video we will see how to install Codenvy on Bitnami LAMP stack that's running on Debian 8. Here are some prerequisites. We need VirtualBox, you can download it from here. We need Putty client for SSH. We need FileZilla because we need to edit some files. We can use the Vim editor, but these steps won't take much long, okay? And after that, the final step would be downloading the VM image. And so we'll see, I'll give you all the links in the text file. So from here, you can download the VirtualBox. From here, you can download the Putty client. From here, you can download the FileZilla. And in the Bitnami, you can create a free account. Go to applications. Okay, then search for LAMP. In the LAMP, we need to install the local installer, so we'll be using this one, the VM image. Okay, we'll go here. Note it down, the SSH username and password is Bitnami. Okay, so we'll be downloading the OVA format, we'll be downloading from here. I've already downloaded it, so we'll proceed to start the VM. The first thing is we will import that file which we have downloaded. Okay, I've already downloaded it. Okay, I'm giving it around 3 GB of RAM, changing its name. Okay, and start to import. It will show you around 1 minute to 2 minutes, then around 6 minutes, but it will be imported in a couple of minutes, so don't worry about that. VM successfully, now we'll start the VM. This is the first time only, the Debian login is Bitnami, the password is also Bitnami. Now it's asking to change the default password which is Bitnami. I'm actually not changing it, so I'll just press enter to pass the screen. Yeah, now we're in it. The screen will automatically change and give you the IP address in a few seconds. Just wait for that. From that IP address, we would be able to access this VM. All the apps we would install over here. Yeah. So from this IP address, we could actually access our virtual machine, and this is the password. You can note it down, because this password will be required for the PHP MyAdmin application. We'll just check it. It's 192.168.0.105. Yeah, so the VM is up and running. Now in the next step, we would enable the SSH and we will use the Putty client. So thanks for this part, we'll meet in the next part again. Hello friends, in the part 2, in this part we will enable the SSH. So just open the VM, login with Bitnami. We can actually use this console also, but you won't be able to copy and paste the commands that I'll provide you. So I'll provide you the Putty client. Okay, so we'll go with the first command. second command. Enable SSH. Then we will just start SSH. Okay, so we have started SSH. Now what we will do, we will create the IDE, the RSA files. These are the RSA files, IDRSA and IDRSA.pub. We will use this command to generate it. Okay, so SSH keygen. It's asking me to whether to save the file. I'll use the default. We can use a passphrase, so I'm just giving it passphrase. Alright, so we have created the RSA files. So now we'll set up the PuTTY client. We'll open PuTTY. The hostname is the VM IP address 192.168.0.105, port is 22. We'll open login as Bitnami. I'm using the default password. I haven't changed the default password from Bitnami. We have logged in. Now we'll set up FileZilla. FileZilla will go to the site manager here under file. We'll create a new site, give it a name. Alright, the host is the VM IP address. Port is 22 is SFTP. Login type is normal, Bitnami. Password is also Bitnami. We'll connect. Okay, so connection is successful. We can see it. Now in the third part, we'll change the port settings. So, see you in the third part. So we are now in the third part. We need to change the port setting, the HTTP port and HTTPS port. Default HTTP port is port 80, but that port is required by Codenvy. So we will change that port. So first, I need to provide write permissions. Oh, sorry. We'll go to stack. Yeah, here's the Apache 2. Alright. Now, we'll go in FileZilla. Open stack. Apache 2. Config. This file. httpd.config. We'll copy it in our desktop. We'll open it with Notepad++. Don't open it with Notepad. First we'll go on line number 52, listen 80, and change it to listen 8080. The second change is on line 200. Server name localhost 8080. Save it and we'll copy it back. Overwrite. Okay. After that, we'll open this Bitnami folder. In Bitnami folder, this bitnami.config file. We'll follow the same procedure, open it with Notepad++. The first is line number 8, we'll change the virtual host 8080. After that 35443, I'm changing it to 8443, and then 43 again 8443. Hit save, then copy it back, overwrite, yes. Okay, so the transfers are finished. Now we'll restart Apache. it's writing Apache started at port 80 because that port 80 has been written in the ctl.sh script. We could change that to 8080, but it's running on port 8080. 192.168.0.105 port 80. The site can't be reached. Okay, so we are done with this part. In the next part, we'll install the Docker. Right. So in this part, we will install the Docker. We'll open the shell, clear the screen. First of all, we will remove any pre-existing Dockers. It's not required, but we can follow it. It won't take much time. Right. Done. Now we'll update and provide you these text files, so don't worry about the commands. Okay, now this one. Now we'll add this. Okay. Done. Okay, now we'll install the Docker engine. Okay, so we'll check if the Docker is installed or not. This one more command left. Start the Docker. Done. I just added the user. Now we'll check if the Docker is installed properly or not. Docker run. Hello world. If the Docker installed properly, we'll be seeing hello world from Docker written on this console. Yeah, here you can see hello from Docker. So the Docker is installed properly. Now we'll install Codenvy in the next part. Thank you. Okay, so in this part, first we'll open some port which are required. These are the port range which are required by Codenvy. Okay, and this is a port which is required by Codenvy. After that, we'll save the IP tables, then we'll install Docker for Codenvy. Alright, so we'll proceed. Open the console, clear the screen. We'll go with the first command. It will open these range of ports. And the second command for this particular port, sorry. Now we'll save the IP tables. Okay, now we'll install the docker. This docker installation will take a bit of time because it will download many images and it directly depends on internet speed. Still, it would take around 10-12 minutes and so just wait for it. So we'll now test it. The default username and password of Codenvy is admin and password. Username is admin. And password is password. So we have successfully loaded our dashboard. In the next video, we'll see to create a workspace to check whether it's running or not. Thank you. So, and this is the last part. In this part, we'll create a workspace to check whether it's working perfectly or not. I'll just give a print statement. Use Python. Alright, create. It's downloading. Okay, so the workspace is running now. I'll create a project. Select Python. Hello world. Run it and you can see the output, hello world. So it's running. Thank you.